Hello, good morning. Today you want to see the book of Matthew chapter 17, Matthew chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16 from verse 13 to 20. I will read Matthew chapter 16 from verse 13 to 20. I will read. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." "But what about you?" he asked. "Who do you say I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus replied, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven. And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosened in heaven." Then he warned his disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Christ. Amen. Today we want to see it is the confession of Peter towards Jesus Christ. This was an important confession of Peter before Jesus, before God. Because this confession was the foundation, it could be the foundation for the church in the world. What could be the foundation? The confession, our faith. Our faith toward Jesus could be the foundation for the kingdom of God. We should have the firm faith. When we have the firm faith, then God can build His church on top, on the foundation, on that foundation. But when we don't have the firm foundation, when we don't have the firm faith, when we are shaken, then that foundation can be shaken also. Then God cannot build His church on that foundation. So this is important. The Peter's confession is very important. The same, our life of faith, then we should also have this firm faith. We should also confess toward Jesus. Jesus, not anyone else. Jesus Christ. Jesus, we should believe in Jesus as our Christ. We should, when we have this, when we live with this firm faith, then even we ourselves, we would not be shaken. Then even God can build His church on this foundation for our life. So confession, Peter's confession, we need to also live with this confession. And then God will work with us. God will work through us for His kingdom. And then this one, when you look at the last verse, verse 20, then don't tell anyone that He was the Christ. Why? Jesus told His disciples, don't tell anyone that Jesus is the Christ. At the time, many people, they didn't believe in Jesus as Christ. But then, shouldn't they teach about it? It was difficult to believe that Jesus is the Christ at that time. It was not, there was no foundation to be able to believe in Jesus as Christ. And then the faith toward Jesus is not about the things to teach. It should be from our confession. He is Christ. He is Christ. Please believe it. We cannot believe that because somebody has said that he is the Christ. I should meet Jesus as Christ, as my Lord, as my Savior. It should be from my experience and confession. So, we also want to live with a similar faith, the same faith like Peter. And then, God can set up his great church in this world on this foundation. So today's story, how does it start? When Jesus, verse 13, when Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, who do people say the Son of Man is? They replied, some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. How people say about me, the Christ, the Jesus? Then there were many opinions among the people. And some people say that Jesus is John the Baptist, the resurrection of John the Baptist. John the Baptist, he died in the prison miserably. But then Jesus' work was so amazing. Then that's how maybe people thought that then John the Baptist, Jesus is the resurrection of John the Baptist. But some others say Jesus is Elijah, coming back to this world. Elijah coming back to this world. This is Jesus. Was Jesus Elijah? Anyway, there was this prophecy. Elijah would come before the Christ comes to this world. In the book of Malachi, you can read also. Elijah would come to this world and he will prepare the way of Christ. So, Jesus is that Elijah who would come to this world to prepare the way for God. But then when you really read it well, then this Elijah, coming back of Elijah, that's who? You can read the book of Luke chapter 1, chapter 2. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3. You can read about the birth of John the Baptist, how it was. I can't tell you everything now. There are so many things. Anyway, some people believed in that, then Jesus is Elijah, a prophet, a great prophet. So there many people were wondering about Jesus' identity, who Jesus is. And then some other people said that Jesus can be Jeremiah or one of the prophets. That's how many people thought about Jesus. Jesus is one of the prophets. Or Jesus is Jeremiah? Or the resurrection of John the Baptist? The same, when you look at in the world, it's also the religion can be also divided according to the understanding of Jesus. Hmm? other religion, they also know about Jesus. But then they don't really believe in Jesus as the Son of God and as the Christ. But they believe that then Jesus is the one of the prophets. Jesus is just one of the prophets. But then they believe the last prophet. That's how they believe. And then some people think that Jesus is a good teacher, a great teacher, but not more. So teacher and Lord, teacher and my Savior, my Lord is different. My teacher and my Savior, my Lord, the Lord of my life, the Savior of my life, it's a different, totally different word. So how do you believe in Jesus for your life? Is Jesus is one of the great teacher for your life? Or Jesus is the owner of your life, the Lord of your life? Who do you think Jesus is? That's important. Who do you think Jesus is? Even we can ask ourselves, who do I think Jesus is? Jesus is whom to your life? So this is the recognition about Jesus. That's very important. Who Jesus is for my life. And verse 15, then Jesus was asking his disciples, what about you? He asked, who do you say I am? Then verse 16, Simon Peter answered, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And this was a great confession. Peter, he had this faith toward Jesus, that he believed that then Jesus is the Christ of this world, the Savior of this world, and you are also the Son of God. That's how I believe. And also that is truth. That is the truth. And also that is the true and the essence of Jesus. Jesus was the Christ. Jesus came to this world as a Christ, as a Savior of this world. And Jesus was the Son of God. That was the essence of Jesus. Yeah, Jesus was also a teacher, it's true. A good teacher, a good rabbi. But then Jesus was over than the teacher rebel. Jesus was the Lord. Jesus was the Christ of this world, for this world. And then Peter, he knew it. He believed it. He knew it. And then it was an amazing confession. That's why Jesus was praising this confession. Jesus replied, verse 17, blessed are you. Yeah, you are blessed. Why? Not many people could know it. Even now, many people does not really believe in this. Jesus is Christ. Many people, they don't believe in this. Even some people, they cannot recognize it. Even though many other people say that, please believe in Jesus. Jesus is our Savior, my Savior, your Savior. But they don't want to accept it. They don't want to believe. Even now. But then, Peter, he believed. This looked very difficult. But then, Peter believed. That's why, you are blessed. How come you believed in me as the Savior, as the Christ for this world? You are blessed by God. It's not that you knew it himself, yourself, but then God guided you to know it. You are blessed by God. Blessed are you. Simon, son of Jonah, here son of Jonah, Simon son of John. John chapter 21, Jesus called Simon, Simon son of John. But here Simon son of Jonah, why is Jonathan? Was it Peter, was it Simon's father Jonah? I don't think so. Do you know the Simon's father? Jonah. Actually, Jesus was, that's my explanation. That's my understanding. Most probably, Jonah is indicating whom? Jesus said sometimes that, don't ask me to show you the another sign. Another sign. But I can show you the sign of Jonah. I will die and I will resurrect in 3 days like Jonah. Jesus was Jonah at the in the Old New Testament. Jonah. Jesus showed the sign of Jonah. Maybe many times when Jesus was calling Peter, Simon, then maybe Jesus was calling Simon like this, son of Jonah, come! Many times while Jesus was alive, living with his disciples, then maybe Jesus was calling Simon, son of Jonah, come! Let's go! Let's go to journey, mission journey! Or sometimes maybe Jesus was calling Simon, son of John, son of John, let's go. Maybe, but I'm not sure. Anyway, here Jesus called Peter, Simon, Simon, son of Jonah, you are blessed. For this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven. This was revealed to you, not by man, but by Father in heaven. The same. It looked to be like we can know God with our wisdom, with our own wisdom or knowledge. But then we need to know that to know God, to meet God, to meet Jesus Christ, it's not by man. The same, we can know the Bible. It looked to be like with our own wisdom or effort to study the Bible. But then as we study the Bible, then we can know God. God can open our heart. Then God can come to our life. The Holy Spirit can come to our life. Then we can know, we can recognize that Jesus is our Lord, my Lord. That is the help of the Holy Spirit. But then through our action of faith, trying to study, trying to know Him, then God can come to our life. Look at the non-believers. It's true. Is it easy for them to believe in God? Even for them to pray God? It's not easy. But then we can pray God. Even we can pray God. It's also the blessing of God. And also when I was young, when I started to pray God, it was really difficult. But then it was the grace of God. I could even open my eye, my mouth. I could pray God. I could open my heart. I could start to pray God. I could start to believe in Jesus as my Lord, as my Savior. That's not by human's power. The same, a rich man is difficult to be saved. A rich man is difficult to be saved. So by man it's difficult. Maybe it's impossible. But by God it's possible. Some other people, he was rich and he was very arrogant. He would never look to seem to believe in Jesus as his Savior. But then, as God do something for his life, then he got so humble later. Then he started to believe in Jesus. God can do. God can also guide us to believe in Him as my Savior. It's not that by man you could know it, but by God, by Father in heaven, you could know, you could recognize this about me as the Son of God, as the Christ. And then, verse 18, and I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock, maybe Peter means rock, on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. I will build my church on this rock. What is rock? On this foundation, firm foundation, the foundation of faith of Peter towards Jesus. When Peter had this firm faith, then on this rock, on this firm faith, then Jesus could, God could build His church for this world. So God could build the great church, the church for this world on the foundation of faith. That's why faith is important. When you come before God with faith, then God can bless us. Even God can do His great work. God can fulfill His great will for this world on our firm faith. So that's how it's so important to have the faith in God. And then verse 19, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosened in heaven. This is what? Authority. God gave the authority, the great authority to Peter. I will give you the key of heaven. So if you bind something on earth, then it will be bound, it will be also bound in heaven. When you loose something in this world, then even it can be loosened in heaven. What is it? When you try to do something in this world, or when you pray for something in this world, it can be also heard by God in heaven. It can be fulfilled according to your prayer. So this is authority. God gave this great authority. As you pray, then God will fulfill it. So God will listen to your prayer. God will respond to your prayer. And as you pray before God, then God will do it according to your prayer. As long as your prayer is according to God's will. So if when you start to pray for somebody, then God will try to save him. But if when you curse somebody, then even God can curse somebody because of that bad person's very bad behavior. So anyway, God would also give the great authority to Peter. So as you pray for something in this world, it can be fulfilled in heaven. God would give you this great authority. So please pray. So even you will do the greater things than me. That's how even Jesus said at other times. As you ask God in my name, then God will do it. God will do it. As you pray God in my name, then God will listen to your prayer. God will fulfill it. The same. So here, we can think about this one. Simon confessed his faith toward Jesus, that Jesus is the Christ, and Jesus is the Son of God. When Simon He believed in Jesus this way. That then God really blessed this Simon's faith. Then God also started to do his great work through this Simon's life. The same as we are living, when we come before God with the faith, with a firm faith, that then God will do his great work, God will fulfill his great work through our life of faith. So the most important thing is our faith. What kind of faith do we have toward Jesus? Jesus, not anyone else. Some other church people said, "Ah, we believe in something else. We believe in something else. Somebody." No. We should believe in Jesus as our Savior. Believe in Jesus as my Savior, as my Lord, as the Christ, and as the Son of God. Jesus is the Son of God. And then, when you believe in this, when you live with this faith, firm faith, then God will be pleased by our faith. Then God will fulfill his great will through our life of faith for this world. So, at this time, you want to realize how important it is, our faith towards Jesus. And then, as we live with this firm faith, then I hope God can bless each one of us, and then God can fulfill his will through our life of faith. So we want to end here. Then let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for allowing us this time to meditate your word. As Simon had the faith, the firm faith, as Simon believed that then Jesus is the Son of God and Jesus is the Christ, when God allowed him to recognize this about Jesus, when he had this firm faith, then God was pleased by it. And then God could fulfill his great will for this world through Simon's life. So as we look at this, then we could also realize that how important it is to live with faith toward Jesus. And as we live with the faith toward Jesus, then please be pleased by our faith. And then please also bless us, bless each one of us. And also please also fulfill your great will for this world through our life of faith. So please be with us. Guide each one of us so that our life can be another blessing for this world. So thank you for all your grace through this time. Then I pray all this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank you very much. God bless you all.